Hello and welcome. Data silos scattered across your enterprise make it cost prohibitive and technically challenging to harness its value through business intelligence or machine learning. The Infor data lake can help solve these challenges, but how can you migrate that data in mass from an on-premise database or a private cloud? The new data loader functionality provides an easy process to simply lift and shift that data along with its associated metadata. The feature itself is twofold: the data catalog crawler, which facilitates registering the metadata, and the data loader, which is responsible for the bulk ingestion. The data catalog crawler enables registering object schemas in bulk, making sure that any data that you put in your data lake is indexed and governed with a robust layer of metadata. The second aspect is the actual bulk ingestion process, which is managed through the data loader functionality. Before we begin, I'd like to mention that the data loader is currently being released as a preview feature. This will change in the future. To enable the preview feature, navigate to Ion Desk on your tenant, and under Configuration, Ion Services, you'll notice a new tab for preview features. You can simply go ahead and check the box to enable it. You don't need to do that for the data catalog crawler functionality. Next, we'll need to perform the one-time process of registering the backend service authorized app that will handle the necessary backend API connection for the data loader. Let's now navigate to Ion API to add a new authorized app. We can call it Data Loader Demo. Next, we'll choose the type as backend services, add the same description here, and finally, let's save to unlock the authorization menu and generate the necessary credentials. We're going to go ahead and download the credentials, and to make things easier, I'll just assign them directly to my account and then click download. Now that we have our authorized backend service credentials, we can go back and register it in Ion Desk. Back to the same view and under the configuration files tab, you'll notice a new menu for data loader. We'll go ahead and upload the Ion API credential file that we just created. And with that, we're all set. Let's now go ahead and create a database connection point to our on-prem database to select and load the objects we're interested in. Under the Connect menu, Connection Points, we'll go ahead and create a database connection point. The key difference here is the type, which would be data loader. We'll populate the rest of the details with our enterprise connection details for our database connection. And once we're all done, we're going to go ahead and do a quick test. It looks like we're all set, so we'll go ahead and save. Now, before we introduce any objects to the data lake, we need to create corresponding object schemas. This would typically be a manual process where you go in and do them one at a time. However, with the new data catalog crawler, we now have two options when we try to add object schemas. We'll go ahead and select Generate from Connection Point. We'll go ahead and select the connection point we created earlier. We then proceed to the next step. This next step allows you to view and select items that you would like to register. You can filter by different types of items here: tables, views, or materialized views. To select the items themselves, there are some handy shortcuts for you here. You can use Control A to select all, you can double click to move items, you can hold Control or Shift to select different ranges and items, but you can also drag and drop. Once you made your selection, you can just press the button at the top to select the items. Next, we're asked to define the object details. We can add a prefix to all the objects added, and we can also rename objects, and it preserves both the original and the new name. You can add additional fields here: the identifier path, selected from columns from the data, and the timestamp path as well, selected from columns from the data. Once we're done with that, we can proceed to the next step and review all the selections that we have made. We can also choose the default action in case a schema already exists. So you can either skip it, require confirmation, or override the existing metadata. We're going to go ahead and choose require confirmation and click generate metadata. The final step is a summary of the actions. As you can see, we have all green check marks, which means everything was successful. In case it wasn't, you'll find action required under the action required tab, skipped items under skipped tab, and then fail items under the fail tab. You'll notice that now that we have taken all the actions we need to the close button is activated, so we can go ahead and click that to finish the process. Let's now do a quick check under object schemas to see our newly added objects. You can see that they have been added already with the right prefix. If you open a sample, you'll see that we have some auto-generated description for context. Let's now proceed with loading our objects. We're going to reuse our previously created connection point here. Under Connect, you'll notice the new data loader's menu item. Let's click Add, and let's fill in all the necessary details here. You'll notice that you have the option to set the number of parallel connections, the action in case a document fails, and the retry time. We'll leave these as default for now. Next, we'll navigate to Documents to select which items to load. As you can see, this list includes all the documents that we defined through the data catalog crawler earlier. Selecting these items follows the same rules as we've seen earlier. You can use Ctrl-A, Shift-Control, or double-click on items to select them. Let's select all and add them. Let's save to validate and proceed to the Operate tab. Now that we're ready to start a new run, let's go ahead and click Start. A prompt will ask you to select either all documents, documents not processed, or specific documents. So we're going to go ahead and select all documents. You'll notice that the global status has changed to running, and the individual status of the run is triggered. When we click on Details, we can see the individual document statuses. We can also refresh to see how the status changes. As you can see, it's progressing through all the documents. And now all the documents are completed. Let's now go to our Data Lake menu to preview and verify the existence of these objects within Atlas. And as you can see, all our documents are visible here. We can open one to check the dates as well as the contents. That concludes our tutorial today. Thank you very much for watching. For more information about InforOS and our data fabric solutions, check the links in the description and make sure to subscribe to our channel to get the latest updates.